back to your book on Through the Labyrinth, the truth about how women become leaders. Can you talk a little bit more about if people resist women's leadership more than men's?
Well, yes, there are many studies that show that insofar as it's enacted in a fairly dominant style. But sometimes it's just the fact you're there. I think in some cases, in some nations in particular, just the fact a woman is in a political role, you know, she may get death threats or whatever, I mean, that people would be hostile towards her, just because she's there as a woman. But in more normal situations, what we see in studies is that when women are clearly enacting leadership in a fairly dominant top-down style, ordering people around, that they get resistance that a man would not get. Okay. He could sort of get away with that. So it's also true that, and this is in some work that I did, you know, it, actually a meta-analysis where we gathered together many studies to look for overall patterns, that it is to some extent true that women enact leadership in a more participative, democratic way. That's possible in organizations. There is some range of, you know, how you do it. And you can do it sort of align yourself with others, or you can do it by telling them what to do. You could come and say, well, we have a problem, which let's think about it and decide.
Yeah.
Or you could say, do this. And women are more likely to use the more democratic participative mode. And that makes sense because of the resistance that they might get otherwise. I particularly noticed Nancy Pelosi on one encounter where the, you know, where the press was there about when they were going to pass on the articles of impeachment. And they kept asking, well, what are you going to do? And she kept saying, well, we are going to decide this. We are going to decide this together, the group of us. And those were the leaders in the House. And I thought, wow, that's probably true. That's probably is how she'll do it, although she has the most powerful voice, certainly.
Yeah.
But that was what I would regard as more typical of a female leader. If a man had been in her role, he might have said, well, I'll decide later.
Right.
Or I will decide. Don't worry, I will decide. And she kept saying, well, and she would kind of gesture. There were other leaders around her from the House. She would gesture at the group and say, we are going to decide that.
This is fascinating because I certainly align more with Nancy Pelosi's style, where I want people to have skin in the game and feel like they have a voice.
Right.
And
it works.
But now I'm questioning it all.
Well, it works.
Yeah.
It's one way that leadership can work and be effective, depending on the traditions of the organization or whatever. Or you can do it more in the directive, top-down style. So one way women negotiate the labyrinth or the role incongruity is by, in fact, being more participative. And then you would get less resistance because they're part of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's, I think, really important.